a great companion called Anas ibn al-Nadr رضي الله عنه. Anas is uncle. You know Anas ibn Malik, the servant of Rasul sallam, his uncle Anas ibn al-Nadr رضي الله عنه. Anas ibn al-Nadr did not attend the battle of Badr, because the battle of Badr was not intentionally a battle. They were going to, you know, attack the caravan of Abu Sufyan, a small brigade of the Muslims, 313 of them, unprepared army, a knife from the kitchen, a rock, a stick, something, you know, something funny. But it turned out to be a battle. So many Sahaba did not attend the battle of Badr. So subhanAllah, when he missed the battle of Badr, what did he say? After the battle, he found out that he missed the first big fight Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had with the enemies of Deen. So he said, radiyallahu anhu, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows me to attend the next battle Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam fights the enemies of Deen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will see what will I do. لَا يَرَيَنَّ اللَّهُ مَا أَصْنَعْ. And he's not making claims like we claim, inshallah, I'll show you what I'll do. He's genuine. So the battle of Uhud came. And when the battle of Uhud came, the Muslims initially were winning the war. And then the problem with the archers, they disobeyed Rasulullah and everything flipped over. And now the Muslims are running. In Kashaf al-Jaysh, they're being attacked from behind and from the front, confusion. Some Sahaba ran away. Some Sahaba sat down. What this man do? He saw his companions running away, fleeing the battlefield. And he saw the enemies of Deen in front of him. So he raised his head to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and said, oh Allah, I am free. Inni abra ilayka mimma sana'a haula. I am free from what these enemies of Deen are doing. Wa a'tadhiru ilayka ma fa'ala haula. And I ask your forgiveness for what our companions and our friends of Muhammad sallam are doing, running away from the battlefield. And then he jumped on his horse and he flew in a suicide mission to the camp of the enemies of Deen. He flew, and on the way, he saw Sa'd ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu. On the way, he saw Sa'd. And Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, just for your understanding, he's not a simple man. It's not like, he's a person with weak iman. Sa'd radiallahu anhu spent 7 years in Deen. He was the leader of Aus, one of the leaders of the Ansar radiallahu anhu. Sa'd ibn Mu'adh, when he passed away, اهتزل موته عرش الرحمن. The throne of Allah shook when Sa'd radiallahu anhu died. Authentic hadith. The throne of Allah shook for the death of Sa'd radiallahu anhu. 7 years of Deen, but when he died, the throne of Allah shook after the battle of the trench, the battle of Al-Khandaq. So Sa'd radiallahu anhu, he was standing there confused also. Anas ibn al-Nadr radiallahu anhu, with no hesitation, with full trust and yaqeen, he happily wants to give himself for Allah. He ran with his horse, saw Sa'd, and then he screamed out to Sa'd, قَالَ يَا سَعْد أَلْجَنَّةِ. Oh Sa'd, paradise! إِنِّي لَأَجْدُ رِيحَ الْجَنَّةِ مِنْ دُونِ أُحُدْ. I can smell the fragrance of paradise beside Mount Uhud. And he wasn't exaggerating, he actually smelled paradise. So Sa'd continues the story. Says, and Sa'd is talking, Allahu Akbar, these people, Wallahi al-Azim, they had iman, my brothers, like mountains. So Sa'd radiallahu anhu is a believer. And a believer knows what he should be doing. So he saw Anas radiallahu anhu doing this, but he is honest. When he went back to Rasulullah after the battle, قال يا رسول الله فوالله ما استطعت ما صنع. O Prophet of Allah, I could not do like Anas. They're genuine. They don't lie to the hearts. So the Prophet of Allah, I could not do like him. I wish I have done like him. I could not do like him, Ya Rasulullah. فَوَاللَّهِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُ مَا صَنَعْ. He went and started fighting, until after the battle, they found his body with 70-something wounds, injuries, either from a spear or an arrow or a sword, more than 70 wounds. وَمَثَّلَ بِهِ الْمُشْرِكُونَ. The enemies of Deen, they mutilated his body. They started tearing him apart. So no one could identify him except his sister. She found out it was him because of a mark he had on his a mark he had on the tip of one of his fingers. لَمْ تَعْرِفُ إِلَّا أُخْتُ مِنْ بَنَانِهِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ. So this man, he wanted Jannah like we do. He wanted the high rank in Jannah. But his wanting is not like our wanting. How much you want the Jannah is not like how much we want Jannah. We all say we want Jannah, we want Jannah. I'm going to go to Jannah. Wake up, pray 1 hour tahajjud every night. 1 hour? You see, Shaykh? It's summertime. You know what time Fajr is? Fajr is at 3:15, 3:10. Yani if I want to sleep a bit after Isha, like, well, I'm going to sleep 2 hours and wake up. No way. I love Jannah and everything, but I want the easy path. Isn't there a shortcut? Find a shortcut to Jannah. Like, I want to skip some, you know? I want to skip the wrong route. There's only one way to Jannah, my brothers. There's only one path called the Salat al-Mustaqim. You know, the system of Allah doesn't change. You want Jannah, sacrifice has to be made.